Hi, Lawrence! Dit is
Hebbal.
En today we're gonna teach you an indoor block sliding.
Indoor block sliding.
Indoor block sliding. Indoor
block sliding. Block sliding into a door.
Ja.
Yeah. Whose turn is it?
Yes, my turn again. So today we decided to have a boys' day.
Boys' rule.
So we eliminated all the girls. We were telling we were filming tomorrow, but it's not true.
Yeah. That's also why Maurits is not here.
Because he always cries.
Sorry, Maupi.
He always cries like a little girl.
Yeah, then he's cold.
My shoulders.
Yeah, my shoulders. My
okay,
arms.
Dennis.
It's cold.
Tell us what we're doing.
Boys.
What is
fuck girls, boys.
What is the drill?
Okay, on the pitch outdoors we do a block sliding, and we made a video about it. If you just look it up, video about outdoors block sliding. But when you do that indoors, it's a bit more difficult because outdoors the ball can play high, but when I do this indoors, there is a possibility that the ball is played onto my body and it's going high away from me. So that's a penalty corner. I can't do anything about it, but I need more control indoors. So what we're gonna do is two different types. If you want to make the space towards the attacker smaller, I do something different than the one I already are in his space. Yeah, and that's what we're gonna try.
Okay.
Okay.
So what is the drill?
One of you is going to pass the ball into the D, and you can decide if you are a bit higher, so somewhere over here, and I'm gonna do a block sliding on you when you shoot the ball, or you are already here and receive the ball over here, and I'm gonna do a block closer to you, and then you're gonna play a sort of a 1v1.
So basically, we're gonna get in the wall, you're gonna try to
get it. Yeah, sort of.
Okay.
I did hit the ball. When I stopped it, otherwise it was a goal. So it's better to have a stroke against than a goal against.
Player ready? Goalie ready?
Bob, have you seen that penalty stroke video?
Yes.
How many goals did you score?
Zero.
Oh. Something I want to get in your head or something.
All right, some pointers.
Okay, first, need to do this. Pointers, there are two different ways, like I said. One is, when you're a bit further away from the attacker that's going to take a shot on goal, you will do a sort of the block sliding, what you do outdoors. But what you do, stay here. What you do outdoors is more sliding, and yeah, you want to stay as high as possible, but still more like this. What it is now is that you make yourself wider, so it's more like this, and then you make yourself wide and your upper body is above your leggards to block the high balls. So it's very important that your upper body is above this leg almost. When you fall down and you need to have your hands over here, then it's going wrong and high ball still going in. Yeah, so you want to be over here. And you aim for the shot over here, just above this foot. That will be the perfect one. Because when is then going high, I have my upper body over here. So this is just for security when it's going wider than you expected. But you want to aim it on here. And don't try the high ball, please.
Yes, do it.
Okay, so that's one. That's one where Poggio, let's say for instance, Poggio was there, he received it on his forehand. I see he's going to turn over there. I slide in and then he's taking the shot. Boom. And then you have it over here. That's more the indoor version of the block sliding, what you do normally outdoors. It's almost similar. But what we don't want indoors is that you have this. Leggers on top of each other. See, a lot of goalies still do it. When you do this indoors, it's too much power to the front. You fall back too much. Ball hits you on the leggers. Ball is going high. Penalty corner. It's a shame. So you want more control by doing this. And keep the ball low. Your upper body above the ball. So when it touches you or your leggers, the ball stays here. Yeah? So no penalty corner. That's one. That's when you are on a bigger distance from Poggio. Let's say Poggio is closer. Poggio is a bit close to me, or I am closer to Poggio. Then it's completely different. Then I don't need to slide to protect my goal, but I stay as close as I can towards him. And then what I do, when the ball is over here, he can take a shot. But now I'm vulnerable. My legs are close, so I can do this, but then here is the open space. What I want to do, what I want to do then is a technique with your knee on the ground. It's sort of a in between standing block and a block sliding. So I do one knee on the ground and one foot on the ground, and my foot is close to my leg over here. Very important over here is that my hips don't look towards Poggio, because then I will tend to fall back. My balance is off, but my hips will go that way. So I'm pointing this way, but my upper body turns back and I'm here. This can go this way, but it's also possible this way. Yeah?
Is there a stupid question maybe? Is there a way to protect your gap?
Yeah, here my hands.
Okay.
So I stay over here, are pretty much forward leaning. So when there's a ball over here, I protect it with my entire body. And now it's very difficult for you to take a shot because I'm very close. Yeah. This is good. Now both sides you can go towards, because I'm on my feet. And that's why this foot is so important. If this foot is on the ground, I can still get up. If I do a block sliding and I'm all down on the ground, getting up takes time. But now, try that way. And I'm there pretty quick because of that left foot. If you move that way, let's say for instance, you are here. Yeah, you move that way, hop, I'm here. And I can still get the ball.
Ref, he's stealing the ball.
Yeah, so from this way, I can easily go to this. And then move again up. Always have one foot in the ground and don't go down. So you can sort of crawl towards the sides. And always have your stick long when you're in the duel. The Poggio has the ball. Up, stick long. Make sure you close this gap. Because in an important thing, Poggio is going to his backhand. Boom, and he's walking into my stick. What most attackers will do then is have the stick in between the ball and my stick. That's what you saw on the World Championship. Pirmin Blaak did it very well. He had a lot of shootouts, had his stick over there while you were like this, had his stick over here, and walked into the stick, boom, shadow, stick shadow. So directly a fall from the attacker. Yeah, so very important to have your stick close to him, to close that space, but also make sure that they get a foul.
Okay.
Now it's gone. But this, I could move to the right because my right foot was still in the ground. It was going high because it was a bit too late.
You're late.
Okay.
You can see how difficult Dan is.
Maybe for the example. This is just one example. Player is going to shoot, going to turn, maybe away from his defender because his defender is going this way, and turn away, and then you can slide in. It's just one example. Can also be when you're on the baseline, someone's walking in into the baseline, the defender is closing him in into the baseline, and then you move out and do this exact same block. So it's not only for a shot, but you can do it on several occasions. That one with the knee on the ground, you see it a lot of goalies do. Important thing that you turn your hip. So when I have my right knee on the ground, I want to turn my hip to the left and rotate my upper body again backwards. Then your heel is towards your knee and you make one big block. And possibility is also to turn your leg a bit to have a bigger surface over here to stop the ball. And then go down and make sure your upper body is above this. Yeah, and that's impossible when you have your hip pointing over there, then you're always falling backwards. Yeah, and you don't want that. So the hip movement is very important.
Hipster.
Hips don't lie.
Hipster.
What if you like?
Can finish it.
If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please let it know in the comments. If you haven't put subscribe to our channel, please do so as well. And put on the bell, the alarm bell.
Jingle bell.
Yeah, then you get a notification when we have a new video.
That's really important. And also like us on Instagram, like all the pictures, especially with me and Dennis in it, and Paul. Oh yeah, and Lawrence, all the boys. Yeah. Yeah.
And Snapchat.
And Snapchat.
And Facebook.
Twitter, Instagram. Yeah.
Bye.
Thank you for watching.